السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله والشكر لله، ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. أحمد الله وأشكره كثيرا that we came and prayed صلاة الصبح جماعة in the house of Allah. نسأل الله أن يتقبل صلاتنا وأن يجعل في ميزان حسناتنا وأن يجعلنا تحت رحمته وتحت انظر رحمتي وتحت حمايتي طوال اليوم and every other day. نحمد الله كثيرا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We're still continuing about the battle of Badr and we're coming close to it, to the end of it. It took a long time for it because it is the first one for the mu'mineen and we you know we're trying to extract so many lessons out of it. And yet last time we stopped at the fact when the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ubayd ibn al-Harith ibn Abd al-Muttalib radiallahu anhu, he was injured and he was carried out back to Medina and he passed away in his way back to the Medina. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam testified that he is really a shaheed. Now, the methodology of the battle itself, Ma'arakat Badr. Now we're going to see that Allah is the one who is running, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who is running the battle himself. Okay. Yes, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is taking the means and he's relying on Allah and he's supplicating to Allah, but everything is actually being done by Allah. And we'll see that. Okay. So, Rasulullah went back again to his tent or to his arish and he start supplicating. He said, Ya Hayy Ya Qayyum, Ya Hayy Ya Qayyum, just provide us with victory, provide us with victory. He's keeping on supplicating to Allah. Then Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, laqad iktunifna al-yawm. Means that, Ya Rasulullah, they already attacked us. And Rasulullah just looked at him and he saw Jibreel descending from the sky and he has a whole bunch of Malaika with him. Okay, that's when Ali ibn Abi Talib came and talked to him about it. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told his companion, the rest of the army, okay, just get up you guys, okay, get up to Jannah, to Jannah arduha al-samawat, just go up to a paradise with the width of the samawat, all the heavens and the earth, okay. He's just trying to boost their ego, to raise their morale, okay. فَوَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. And he's swearing by Allah, okay, anybody's gonna fight today, okay, and fighting and muqbilan, and he's really forward, not mudbiran, okay, and he will die fi sabilillah, muhtasiban fi sabilillah, just fight for the sake of Allah, and he's patient, Allah will enter him to Jannah. Very nice promise to everybody in the army of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they really are confident and they are really going ahead. Then what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he just took a handful of dirt in his hand, okay? And he read some Quran on it and recited some Quran on that handful of the dirt. And then he threw it away. He threw it away like that. Okay. And that dirt, okay, each particle of the dirt, just one particle, each one just went into the eyes of one of those kafirin. Every kafir had one piece of that dirt in his eye. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he threw it away, he said, shahat al-wujuh. Shahat al-wujuh means the faces are really ugly. Okay, and he threw it away, the faces, you guys, faces, you're ugly. And then he said to the Muslim, shuddu means that go ahead, attack. And then he threw this away, and Muslimin just came out very, you know, like very courageous, and is screaming and saying, Ahadun, 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 Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and they really went into the battle of the battlefield. Okay? And people start fighting, and the swords are, you know, salil al-siyuf everywhere, okay?
The sound of the swords,
okay, is everywhere, okay? And big battle, okay? And the, you know, the dirt are just following, you know, the whole thing, you know. And the people later on, who attended that battle, okay, and whoever really turned to become Muslims, whoever declared Muslims from the other group, from the Quraysh Mushrikeen, they say, they described what happened to them during the Ma'araka, okay. They said, in Hazamna Yawm Badr, he said, we were really conquered and defeated during the day of Badr. And we were hearing, نحن نسمع صوتا قوقع الحصى في الطاس. And they described exactly what happened to them. Okay, they said, we were defeated in the day of Badr. Okay, and while we were fighting, we were hearing like sound of when you throw stones or particles of stones or dust in tasa, okay, in a bowl, okay, when you throw dirt or, you know, pieces of stones in a bowl, you hear it. They said, we heard that. As if the rain is dropping in, you know, into tasa of in a bowl. And we felt that in our heart, and we got really very scared, and that was really very scary for us, okay? Anyway, this is just describing what happened. Those are the people who are really declared Islam after the battle, okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is not really just words or story, somebody really saying it. Allah actually said that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. فَلَمْ تَقْتُلُوهُمْ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ قَتَلَهُمْ وَمَا رَمَيْتَ إِذْ رَمَيْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ رَمَى وَلِيُبْلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْهُ بَلَاءً حَسَنًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ. That's for Surah Al-Anfal. Allah is telling the mu'mineen that you guys, you're not really the one who really fought. Allah is the one who's really fought. And he said, you did not kill them, but God killed them. And you did not throw when you threw, but God threw. You didn't throw the nibble of Allah. He did that. And that he might test the believers from him was a good test. وَلْيُبْلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ مِنْهُ بَلَاءً حَسَنٌ. He will test them. Okay. And indeed, Allah is all hearer and all knowing. So that's what Allah is actually describing what happened. Allah is the one who's really the cause of the victory of the mu'mineen. So, yes, فَأَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ رَمَيْتَ. Yeah, your army is really through, and your army actually in the battlefield. Okay. And you took the means, and you took the means, okay, and relied on Allah. this is what Rasulullah is doing before the beginning of the battle. And واستغثت بالله فأوحى لك, and you seeked help from Allah, and Allah responded to you. Okay, and Allah said that. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Okay. إِذْ تَسْتَغِيثُونَ رَبَّكُمْ فَاسْتَجَابَ لَكُمْ أَنِّي مُمِدُّكُمْ بِأَلْفٍ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ مُرْدِفِينَ. Okay. So, as we said always, whenever you want to do something, okay, take the means, do your job, do what you're supposed to do, okay, and your heart is full of relying on Allah, and you're saying, this is gonna happen by the wish of Allah, but you have to do. You don't just say doing nothing and say Allah will do it. No, you have to do that. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he supplicated and he took the means and he arranged the army and he told everybody what to do and everything. And he actually is relying on Allah and asking Allah to give him the victory. So take him al-asbab and اتكال على الله. استغيثون ربكم فاستجاب لكم أني ممدكم بألف من الملائكة مردفين. When you sought help from your Lord and he responded, Lord responded to you, indeed Allah says, indeed I will assist you with thousands of angels following one another. مردفين, just group after the other, what you know, sequence after each other. Okay, that's group. So Allah actually is really talking to the malaika, okay, how to run the battle. He's telling them, he's teaching them what to do. And Allah says in this case, he said, iz yuhi rabbuka ila al malaika anni ma'akum. Allah is telling the malaika that you angels, you my angel, I am with you. Okay. فَثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. So, ثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. ثَبِّتُوا means killing the الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. ثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ. Make the الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا stand still. Stand, you know, stand. Okay. فَأُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. I'm going to translate that. فَأُلْقِي فِي قُلُوبِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الرعب. فاضربوا فوق الأعناق واضربوا منهم كل بنان. That's سورة الأنفال. Okay, so Allah is telling the malaika, yeah, he's sending the malaika to fight, okay, and he's telling them what to do. Allah is telling the malaika what to do. So he said, when your Lord revealed to the angels, indeed I am with you, so strengthen those who believe. ثبتوا, make them sure, make them stand still. Okay, stand. I will cast terror in the heart of those who disbelieve. فَأُلْقِ الرَّعْبَ فِي الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. So strike them above the necks, فوق الأعناق. Okay, and also every fingertip of them. Just cut every fingertip of them. Okay, so he told them exactly what to do. Okay, wouldn't be enough that Allah doesn't reveal that ayah and, you know, let the battle to go on and the Muslims will gain victory in the end? No, because we, as we said, we mankind, we need to see things on, you know, in front of us. So he sent Malaik and lots of people from the army of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they saw al-Malaika. And they saw what the Malaika did after that. You're gonna see people were dead, okay? Her head was shaved, her fingertips were cut, okay? This is an indication, something you can feel it, okay? You can feel that. It's true that وَمَا النَّصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, that actually only victory is from Allah. ولكنهم and as I said I'm sorry about that And as I said, Allah sent Malaik especially so we can really believe and we can really trust and we can really, you know, be, you know, having big ego to go and fight, okay, and do that. Let's see here, okay, he says, is yuhi rabbuka ila al-malaikati anni ma'akum. Allah says, is telling the malaika that, go ahead you, my angels, I am with you. So being with Allah, that's the most important thing, okay? Because malaika by themselves, if Allah is not with them, they cannot do anything. It's like us. If Allah is not with us, if we are not fi ma'iyat Allah, okay, we cannot really achieve anything. So Allah is telling malaika that. So Allah is just making put tranquility and making assurance for the malaika. Just to go, I am with you. Okay. And then he said, ثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Okay, ثَبِّتُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا means you, my angels. Okay, ثَبِّتُوا, make my believers, make them strengthen, make them to be sure, make them victorious. And I am the one who's gonna cast terror in the hearts of the disbelievers. So that ayah is actually telling Malaik what to do. وَضْرِبُوا فَوْقَ الْأَعْنَاقِ وَضْرِبُوا بِنْهُمْ كُلَّ بَنَانٍ. Okay, he's telling also the Malaik what to do. Okay, just ضربوا فوق الأعناق means kill all the, you know, whatever the disbelievers are. And ضربوا فوق ضربوا كل بنان means cut their fingertips. Okay, banan, this one. Cut this one, fingertip. Because if you cut this one, you cannot hold your sword. So the swords will fall down and then it will be easy to have them as hostages, right? So that's, you know, that's the technique. Allah is telling Malaika what to do. Okay? So, in fact, after all these revelations and all this ayat, Allah is the one who's really running the whole battle. Okay? So we have to learn that if Allah is with you, you will never be defeated. You will be always victorious as long as you are patient, okay, and you have a good creed, and you have a good trust, and you have good manners, and you love everybody, love each other, and trust your Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and take the means, always take the means, do your job, and rely on Allah. Okay. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, in this battle, okay, he said, Abu Bakr says, oh, I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of a sudden he just stood up and he took his shield and his sword and he's going to the battlefield. And Rasulullah did that and he says, Rasulullah, سيهزم الجمع ويولون الدبر. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The people, some shall soon. رسول الله said, soon shall the crowd will be defeated and they will turn their backs. ويولون الأدبار. That's سورة القمر. رسول الله, get ready, took his shield and his sword. And he went to the battle, okay, and he said that statement, سَيُهْزَمُ الْجَمَ وَيُوَلُّونَ الدُّبَرِ. That's Surah Al-Qamar, okay? Actually, that surah, actually, was not really revealed at that time. It was revealed in Mecca, okay, later on. And Abu Bakr says, okay, that is the first time I realized what is meant by this ayah, when Rasulullah said it, okay? Before it was revealed, Rasulullah said this is exactly, okay, but before it was revealed to him. And Abu Bakr says, هذه الآية نزلت ونحن في مكة. He said, it was revealed when we were in Mecca. فوالذي بعثه بالحق ما علمت تهويلها إلا يوم بدر. He didn't really knew about it, okay, except in the day of Badr. So it revealed in Mecca and being تحققت and happened in the day of معركة بدر. Okay. It's enough today. Anybody has any questions or any comments or any additions? Okay. اللهم إني دعم فأمين. نسأل الله الذي يسبح بحمده كل شيء أن يجعل لنا صحة تامة وبركة دائمة ويكفينا وإياكم كل هامة وأن يحفظنا من كل عين لامة ويشملنا بكريم عفوه وجميل ثوابه ورحمته ويتمم علينا بفضله وكرمه وأن يجمعنا ووالدينا والمسلمين في الفردوس الأعلى من الجنة. يا مقسم الأرزاق اقسم لنا في هذا الفجر من توفيقك ورضاك وغناك وتيسير الأمور. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Thank you very much. Thank you.